Well, hey there, everybody. Nate Miller here with Miller Retirement Group and host of Retirement Rescue Radio. Long time no talk. It's been a little while. We've been very busy here. And, you know, every time you incorporate something new, sometimes other things need to get slid off to the side for a little while or a season. And that was the podcast here for several weeks. And we're growing. That's the good news. So we've got, I've been hiring quite a few more people for a number of reasons. One, we're growing into new markets. Two, we want to make sure that we've got enough clients to make sure that we're getting good service for enough employees that we're giving good service to our clients. And so we've been hiring more people here too. So we're definitely growing. Things are going well. You might see a couple other, or hear, depending on how you're consuming this, a couple other advisors on our podcasts here in the future as well. So things are going well. But yeah, had to kind of pause the podcast there for a little while. And but now I want to go through a couple things here today. We're going to go through some fun stuff and also some financial stuff. We'll try to make those two the same, fun and financial. But two, we all kind of want to give a little bit of an update on what's been going on this year here since, you know, the podcasts have been out for a while. So we haven't touched on a few topics. So inflation, interest rates, stuff like that in the market and where things we're seeing. But as far as the fun thing, I want to go over that first. And maybe it's fun for you guys. It actually wasn't as fun for me because I just received my very first invitation to a retirement planning seminar. So yes, we get those as well. And I guess that means I'm officially old enough to start receiving those. Don't worry, guys. I don't have any plans on retiring anytime soon, but apparently I'm on some kind of list that thinks I'm going to be retiring soon. And so I wanted to take this opportunity, though, to help all of you out there that are getting these invitations on a regular basis on how to really understand who it is that you're going to be listening to. Because those little tiny, you know, small print disclosures that you find on a lot of these actually lets you know what type of advisor you might be coming to listen to. And so I want to help you guys if you're looking for, you know, an insurance only guy, or if you're looking for a securities only guy, or maybe you're looking for someone who does more, you know, complete overall financial planning, then each one of those I'm going to help you understand how to read these invitations so that you know what type of advisor you're looking for, which one of those that you're looking for. And one is not necessarily better than the other. It just matters on what you want. Like if you're looking for just one specific thing on the insurance side, well, maybe you should talk to an insurance only guy. If you're looking for just one specific thing on the security side, maybe you talk to an advisor that's all he does. But again, if you're looking more for an overall plan, you probably want to look for somebody that's in both of those worlds. So this specific one, I'm not going to give any names of any companies or anything like that, but I just want to help you guys understand the verbiage that you want to pay attention to in order to understand what type of advisor you're going to be listening to whenever you go to any of these retirement planning seminars. So this one right here in the after the invitation and after it talks about where it's going to be held, what restaurant it's going to be at, the disclosure says insurance products offered through, I'm just going to call it XYZ company. All guarantees backed by the financial strength of the issuing company. We do not offer investment, tax, or legal advice. Always consult with your own qualified advisors. And then it says they're not affiliated, approved, or endorsed or authorized by the Social Security Administration or any other government agency. And the event's not sponsored or endorsed by the restaurant. That's normal language right there. None of the presentations are ever sponsored or endorsed by the restaurant. They're just the venue, and the views, information, and opinions expressed are of the presenter and do not necessarily respect or represent those of the restaurant or its employees. And that right there is standard language. The part you want to pay attention to is how it says insurance products are offered through, you know, XYZ company. All guarantees are backed by the financial strength, and it says that they don't offer any type of investment, tax, or legal advice. So that's the part you want to pay attention to. And it says specifically insurance products. It doesn't have any information in there about any securities that are offered. And matter of fact, it says that they do not offer investment services. And so that means that this person would be insurance only. That would be all they sell. And actually, I went out to their website because on the invitation, it does have their name on here. And yeah, there is no mention of any securities being offered by anyone, right? And so that is how you know that this person is going to be an insurance only person. They're not going to be talking about the market and investments because they can't. They're not licensed to. So it's going to be insurance only. And just to give you guys a little, a comparison or a contrast. So our disclosure, it does say, you know, insurance products are offered through the insurance business Miller Retirement Group, but it also goes on to say Miller Retirement Group is also an investment advisory practice that offers products and services through AE Wealth Management LLC, a registered investment advisor. And so there is the disclosure that mentions securities, right? So we've got investment advisory practice, right? Products and services through AE Wealth Management. And so that's how you know. And so that's, we're both. Because so we have insurance licensed products. We have the securities products. So it lists both of those in the disclosure. If somebody was not insurance licensed, it wouldn't have anything in there about insurance. It would basically just say securities are offered through, you know, in my case, AE Wealth Management, or if it's through somebody else, it could be ABC Securities, you know, Incorporated or LLC, whatever. But it will mention something about securities or investment advisory services. And so that's how you know whether or not somebody is in the securities industry. And if it has both disclosures, both insurance disclosures and securities disclosures, that person is in both of those categories. And most likely from my experience, I'll just say that from my experience, is going to be an advisor that does more holistic planning rather than just transactional stuff. And so there you go. Hopefully that helps you guys understand who it is you're looking for so you can better determine who you actually want to go end up hearing from. Right. So there's the fun stuff right there. I'm old enough now that I'm starting to get those. So yeah, end of an era, I guess. The other thing I would like to talk about here is, yeah, kind of just where we see things right now and what's been going on as far as interest rates and inflation and all that. So